Advertising is the largest source of online revenue for most news organizations, so getting it right is critical to the health of your business. I'm Robbie Brown from the Google News Initiative, and this video is part of a series to try to demystify Google technology for the news industry. If you enjoy this video, please take a look at the others we created about Google Search, about analytics, and about YouTube. But today we're focusing on ads. Specifically, we're going to walk you through three different Google Ads products that are used by news organizations around the world. Those products are AdSense, AdMob, and Ad Manager. We'll outline the differences between these products, show you how to get started, and look at advertising strategies that we've seen work at other news companies. Let's get started by answering a few of the most common questions that we hear. Number one, how much money can I make in digital advertising? Of course, there are many business models in the news industry and many factors that might impact the answer to this question. But with those variables in mind, Google has created a calculator to help you estimate the amount of advertising revenue your website might be able to generate. Here's how it works. You enter your news organization's specific information. The region of the world you're in, your monthly page views, the cost of an impression on your website. And we'll calculate the estimated revenue given those assumptions. If you don't know certain information, that's okay. The calculator provides typical figures from other news organizations. So, for example, let's say you're a news organization based in North America. Your website gets 100,000 impressions per month, and you have $5 CPMs. That's the cost of running 1,000 ads on your website. And let's say that half of your ads are sold programmatically or by automated algorithms, and half are sold directly by your sales team. Well, in this case, you can expect to earn around $700 or $800 per month from those digital ads. In the calculator, you can then see how changing some of those assumptions may affect your overall revenue and decide which strategy makes the most sense. For instance, if you increase the number of ads on a page or improve the viewability of those ads, you can see the impact on your total revenue. Question number two, which Google product should I use? AdSense, Ad Manager, or AdMob? To answer that question, let's look at these products in a bit more detail. First, AdSense. AdSense is the ideal product if you're looking for Google to do the work for you. It's built to provide the easiest possible advertising revenue and can scale even to publishers with tens of millions of monthly page views. AdSense is designed for publishers with a standard web format, no ad operations team, and those organizations who don't plan on selling advertising directly themselves. Ad Manager, on the other hand, is designed for publishers that need more help managing direct deals as well as programmatic deals across many formats. So, for example, if your news organization operates a website and an app or even a broadcast channel, Ad Manager can help manage all of that digital advertising in one place. Ad Manager is also for organizations managing complicated setups with third-party networks serving ads across multiple platforms and formats. We know most news publishers, especially local ones, rely heavily on direct deals for revenue, so if that sounds like you, Ad Manager may be the right fit. I do want to flag one common misconception, which is that Ad Manager ads are somehow better than AdSense ads. That isn't true. The advertising for both products comes from the same advertising sources like Google Ads, Google Display and Video 360, and authorized buyers, so ad performance is comparable. On to product number three, AdMob, which focuses specifically on mobile apps. So if your news organization has its own app, this is definitely a product worth considering. And just like with AdSense, if you don't have a direct sales team, AdMob may be right for you. So let's recap quickly. If you're new to advertising and looking for an easy, automated solution, you might start with AdSense, or if you have an app, with AdMob. However, if you're looking to sell advertising directly, access third-party networks, and manage programmatic ads across multiple devices, try Ad Manager instead. And we have a link below this video that compares the three products in more detail in case that's helpful. Okay, let's take one more commonly asked question. This one is actually a question about questions. Is there someone from Google who can answer my advertising question? Well, if you have a question about Google's ad products, we'd strongly encourage you to start by visiting our help centers. There are dedicated help centers for AdSense, AdMob, and Ad Manager. On each of these sites, you can read through questions raised by other news organizations, see how their issues have been resolved, or pose your own question to the Help Center community. If you need more assistance than that, you can also submit a question using the Help Center forms, which are listed below this video. But please note, those forms are not yet available in every region of the world. If you're new to digital advertising, you may be wondering, how do I even get started? So we're going to walk you through the steps required to set up the most simple Google advertising product, AdSense. Step one, sign up. You can go to the link on the screen now to get started. Step two, connect your website. Once you've created an account, you'll need to tag your site with a little snippet of code, which is provided automatically. Step three, begin monetizing. Once you're approved, you can start looking through the setup manually, identifying the types of ads you'll want to place on your website, generating them, and then tagging your site. Or you can use Auto Ads, an automated offering that does most of the legwork while allowing you to retain control of the user experience. With Auto Ads, you can still make edits and add preferences to ensure ads work for you and your organization. It's worth noting that while this process is fairly simple, it doesn't happen overnight. It could take potentially a few days or even weeks to complete all of the steps. If you'd like a longer step-by-step tutorial, we recommend watching this video about AdSense. And for AdMob, we recommend following the instructions in this video. We also have a tutorial video for Ad Manager. There are a few more steps to getting set up with that, but you can get started by signing up in the link beneath this video. Okay, so that's how you get started. But how do you make the most of these ad products if you're already using them? In this last section of the video, we'll look at four different best practices for news organizations when it comes to advertising. Not all of these may make sense for you, but we want to cover a variety of tactics, and you can choose. The first suggestion, ensure your ads are standard sizes. You're more likely to receive ads if you match the sizes that advertisers use. The Interactive Advertising Bureau, or IAB, recommends the sizes that you see here. If you're not sure about the size of your ads, right-click on them on your website and select Inspect to view the sizing details. Second, we recommend that you focus on the highest priced formats. Often these are video ads or what are called sticky ads that float with a user rather than banner or text-based ads. To get started, why not test out video advertising inventory? Video ads typically have higher CPMs than display ads, so if your news organization is open to video storytelling, there's definitely an opportunity to drive traffic and ad revenue to this type of coverage. If you decide to add a video section to your website, we recommend placing the video player at the top of the page and increasing the size of the videos, both of which can boost viewability. For more help, we'd refer you to a YouTube tutorial on how to plan your ad inventory structure. And finally, we recommend your video player either has what's called sticky behavior, which means the video remains in view as the user scrolls down the page, or that you implement what's called picture-in-picture, which is where your video shrinks into a small player so that someone can keep watching it while they're using other apps on their mobile device. To get started with either of these options, check out the links found beneath this video. A third tip is to increase the viewability of your ads. Viewability refers to whether or not it is seen by someone when they visit your website. The more viewable, the more ad impressions, and the more ad impressions, the more money that you make off of those ads. But how do you increase your viewability? We'll share a few ideas. First, be careful where you put your ads. For example, our data has shown the highest viewability rates are for ads placed above the fold on the homepage, which means they're situated in the upper half of a website and therefore visible without even scrolling down. But don't forget about user experience. Too many ads above the fold will make your page appear cluttered and potentially drive visitors away. Next, we'd encourage you to explore what's called lazy loading. This means certain parts of your website load faster than others, which increases the speed and the viewability of your ads. If you don't have lazy loading, you can learn how to implement it by visiting the link on the screen now. A note of caution, while lazy loading can increase the speed of your website, it can also decrease the number of ads that fire on parts of your website that a user is not using. This means you'll need to monitor the impact of lazy loading carefully in order to find the right balance for your website. Fourth, we recommend that most publishers sell both direct and programmatic ads. Programmatic ads are bought and sold using automated bidding processes. They enable publishers to optimize their revenue by selling more ads to more advertisers than direct sales alone. However, there is still a role to be played for direct ads, a process in which ads are bought and sold by a member of your sales team. In fact, for many news organizations, direct ads represent the majority of their ads. So utilizing both streams maximizes a publisher's reach and revenue opportunities. This video is just an introduction, but we hope it's been helpful. In the description below the video, you'll find links to other Google resources to help you make progress with your digital advertising. Thank you, and goodbye for now.